In part two, Michelle encourages us to develop a spiritual immune system and to take personal accountability to help shift the state of the world. He speaks for peace to overcome the war of the mind and advocates that mental medicine is an attitude for calming the mind. Michelle says when you calm the mind, you become kinder and more grateful, projecting peace into the world to help calm one another. He gives personal examples from his life, along with his experience shifting the mindset of prisoners. Using vibration and meditation instead of words, he has been able to change the lives and the statistics of reincarceration, facilitating freedom in many forms. Don't miss out on all the show segments and hear more incredible stories of my guests on future episodes when you like and subscribe to my YouTube channel and Facebook page, Beth Bell Live. We're back with Michelle Pascal, and we were talking about probably a very important topic, which is meditation, but also the question of how, and you were addressing that, which I think was, I just love how you approach it with the word calm. It immediately sends a vibration through that word.
Yes.
And I love that you talk about the vibration as a way to do a transmission. And for me, I don't know if you know this about me, but I wanted to meditate. I knew I needed to meditate. I was in the middle of my corporate, chaotic corporate career, but I just couldn't. I would sit down, and you know, the longer I sat, the more I realized how much I didn't get done in that 10, 15 minutes that I set aside. And one day the universe put me in Hawaii on vacation with a nice camera, and I started photographing flowers close up. I became mesmerized and just could not pull myself away, didn't want to pull myself away. And then realized over the years, which is I'm called the flower whisperer.
The flowers were your meditation teachers.
They were.
Because a flower gives an energy.
Exactly.
All is energy. A flower has an amazing energy. Yes. It can be to meditate with a tree, with the ocean. This is the book of the nature.
Yes.
And all is written in the book of the nature.
Yes. So I wanted to mention that because what I also loved about what you said is that it comes in a different form for everyone.
Yes.
You know,
everyone.
For a surfer, it might be the ocean.
Exactly.
Right? So I think we have a lot of there's a lot of judgment sometimes that people place on themselves around what is meditation, how do I do it? I'm not able to sit
I will say that teach me my Rinpoche. Spiritual ego is the worst ego.
Yes.
So
yes.
No spiritual ego. Everyone, you have your own way. This is very important what you say because it is also the vision, genius vision of Deepak Chopra. Deepak, he said to me and to Gabriela Wright, we have not the key to save the world. Everyone has his own key.
Yes.
So, as you say, for you, it can be a flower. The smell of a rose can calm the mind. Or flower, to give attention to a flower. Or dog.
Yes.
My dog is my guru.
Yes.
I mean, the vibration of my dog helps me to calm the mind. It can be, as you say, for a surfer, the ocean. It can be for someone to cook. I mean, everyone, we have our own way to calm the mind. And with Deepak and Gabriela, we create this world movement, and our idea is everyone can share the solution. What is your solution? What is your solution? Everyone, we need to bring our solution, because this world is too much difficult.
Yes.
Yesterday, I sing for the funeral, the cremation of someone young. He commits suicide. So, as you know, suicide is the second cause of death in America from 10 years old. So there is a moment we must say, okay, we need to change this world.
And from 10 years old speaks volumes for, this isn't about like someone's gotten themselves into financial trouble and they're, you know, I mean, this is the inner calling and the inner wisdom and the inner bliss that needs to be accessed early on.
It is the reason why your show, your question, your approach, every one of you. It is so important. So again, I never say, oh baby, I found the key with the prisoners. Yes, this approach saved 80%. And it's not only me, it's all my teachers.
Yeah.
So we are a team of now many teachers, and they teach for the prisoners or celebrities or corporate people. So when we guide the person, we calm the mind. And the person feel better immediately. But also we calm the mind in the situation of the stress. Because if we calm the mind of the person, for example, at the workplace, when you go back to the workplace the day after, your workplace becomes day after day the place to calm the mind.
Yeah.
So my office becomes my yoga studio.
Yeah, well, I always
say... The
same
in the traffic. In the traffic, we teach for Uber drivers. What we do with Uber drivers? We go on the freeway at the rush hour in Los Angeles. And we guide the Uber driver, so we share a vibration, very calming.
Yeah.
So day after day, we reprogram the perception of the traffic for the Uber driver. After a few days, the brain naturally understand and say, oh, my car in the traffic, this is my refuge, my shrine. Mm-hmm. I can be calm in the chaos.
Yes.
So this approach helps a lot of people. But again, it's not the key. This is one of the key. And you, I am sure many people who listen your show have many ideas, solutions, and all together we must be end by end to save this world. But your show has a big responsibility. Mm. What you do today, it's so important. Everyone, we have a responsibility. You can save the life of someone. Mm. It's not a hope.
Yeah.
Because imagine, we never know the consequence of what we do.
Yes.
Maybe someone is watching your show and say, oh my gosh, I love the show of this person. I love to see many shows, oh my gosh, and it becomes my favorite show. It's a sort of spiritual talk show. I learned many things. You asked my friend Daniel Gutierrez.
Yes.
Daniel is full of love. Just when we see Daniel, wow, we feel happiness. Daniel is magical. So everyone, we bring our energy together. But everyone, we have the responsibility facing everyone.
Yes, thank you. And through the show, the Pollinating Planet with Love show, I feel that the universe has divinely guided me to come up with the Pollinating Love Mudra. And the mudra is all about helping people to connect. And I like how you talk about transmissions. And at the end of our episode, I would love for you to do the Pollinating Love Mudra with me if you're willing. But I want to talk a little bit more about energy and the transmission between people that can happen. You do a lot through singing. You do that just by showing up and exuding your calmness. How do you guide people to find what it is that's right for them? If someone's just sitting here going, I don't know, I have disease, I have financial problems, I have relationship problems, I have all these problems. I'm clearly in my stress. I'm clearly in a place where I should be really looking at all of these situations as my guru, but they don't know how to find it.
Again, I love your question. For me, it just my experience, I was abused, I mean, I work for prisoners, it's just my experience. There is only one answer. It's to calm the mind. When the mind is calm, the mind is clear. So for example, for professional problem, money problem, we need to find a solution. In America, you, me, everyone, we need to make money.
Yes.
We need to be active. So there is a moment, of course, we have money issues. There is no life without money issues. There is no ocean without waves.
Yes.
Bon. So when the mind is calm, the mind is clear. And suddenly we can find the solution.
Yes.
When we are sick, we know every doctor explained that. Now we know that it's, there is no debate that when we are stressed, we destroy our immune system. So when we are calm, we boost our immune system. So the more to be calm, it's an amazing mental medicine. In Nyingma tradition, in Buddhism, we talk about the spiritual immune system. We develop a spiritual immune system. Many mental attitude, mental medicine. So when we develop mental medicine, we are not sick.
Are you saying multi?
Mental. Sorry for my French accent.
No, I love the French accent.
Mental medicine.
Mental medicine.
Yes. A mental medicine, it's not a tips, it's not an advice, it's an attitude to calm the mind. So, of course, one of the first thing for that, it's how we live, where we live. When we live with people stressed in a very stressful environment, it's more difficult than if we make the choice, if we have the possibility to live in a life more healthy. When we drink alcohol, when we take drugs, of course we destroy your brain capacity, so it's a disaster so soon. So of course, we must be more healthy, physically, but for the mind. I teach many times for champion of sport. It's very interesting to see how they are stressed.
Yeah.
And they don't realize enough that the body is here.
Yes.
The performance is here. When I say here, it's not, oh baby, you must be yourself. I don't say that. It's, we must calm. Again, when we calm the mind, we upgrade the brain capacities.
Yeah.
I love in Buddhism the four layers when we say we are more present. If I calm my mind, I am more present to you.
Yeah.
I am more present to you. I am more present to this flower, to the world love. I am more present, so to be more present. When we are more present, we become more intelligent. We are more intelligent. We find a solution facing our problem. More present, more intelligent, more kind.
For
calm and kind, it's connected.
Yes.
More kind, more grateful. The goal of the life is to be grateful.
To be grateful.
To be more. The goal of the life is to be more alive.
Yes.
I am more alive. I realize that every minute is so precious because life is like that, so short. Mm-hmm. Maybe this is the last time that I talk to someone in my life.
Yeah.
I cross the street, poof, there is a car, bye bye.
I hope not. Yeah, I understand.
It's all. So. When we calm the mind, we are more intelligent, we are more kind, and we are more grateful. So for me, when we calm the mind, we upgrade the capacities, the possibilities to find solutions for money problem, love problem, take the good decision, etc., etc. Again, the answer for me, it's to calm. We can have every tips, any coach. If we are stressed, nothing works.
Yeah. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
Blossom Bliss products are designed to help empower pure love and purpose in your life. It's through the power of words, flowers, and symbols that our products assist you in creating a blissful life. The power of words in our mini mantra word bar necklaces assist you in setting and blossoming your personal intentions. The affirmation cards leverage the power of flowers by providing daily inspiration. And the power of symbols in our life journey bracelets are great reminders of the things that bring us peace, joy, and love. Products are made and blessed in Bali with love by Balinese artisans who work with empowered hearts. When you purchase jewelry with a bee charm, we donate to save the bees. Join us in pollinating the planet with love. Go to our website, blossombliss.com. Again, that's blossombliss.com.
Thanks for joining in to hear the life journey lessons and pearls of wisdom of me and my guests. Be sure to hear all three segments when you subscribe to my YouTube channel and receive reminders to upcoming shows and segments. The full episode is also available at bethbell.me/show. If you found this inspiring, please give this episode a like and a big thumbs up. If you want to hear more, follow me or hit the bell for reminders at Beth Bell Live on Facebook and YouTube. I'd love to have you join the mission of pollinating the planet with love.